Hi friends, in this session we will do one exercise on procurement of consumable material. We will create a purchase requisition for a consumable material, then convert the purchase requisition into a purchase order, and then do the goods receipt for the purchase order and post invoice for the purchase order. We will create purchase requisition for two consumable materials, one material with without master record and other is material with master record. I have the exercise sheet here. Let me share with you here. Create a purchase requisition for two materials. Item number one, some description, quantity 1 piece. Two, material number 100, quantity 5 piece. We need to use this material group for this first item without master record, 00107. Purchase organization, purchasing group, plant, delivery date, cost center, valuation price, everything is given here. That is for the first item. Second item, 5 pieces. Out of 5 pieces, 3 pieces for cost center 1220, GL account 400,000, and 2 pieces for cost center 4300, same GL account. Okay. For partial invoice, distribution is to be proportional. The requisitioner uses the tracking number PRTI_1001. Okay. Then we will save the purchase requisition. The transaction code to create a purchase requisition is ME51N. I will go to the transaction ME51N. Okay, first one is copy this text. Testing instrument Philips 5105. Yeah, that is copied here. Quantity is 1. Unit of measure is piece. Put piece. Delivery date is 3 weeks from today. 1, 2, 3. Today is 29 September. Plant material group is 00107. Plant is 1100. Enter. Okay. We need to. First, we need to enter the account assignment category here. K in the cost center. Yeah, it will ask for the cost center 1220. GL account is 400,000 already there. Yeah. Now purchasing group unit, it is asking. Okay, use purchasing group 001. Fine. What is the purchasing group? That's fine. That's done. Okay. Valuation price is 520 euro. That is okay. That is done. First item. Second item. Material number 100, 5 pieces. So, out of this, 3 pieces for one cost center and GL account 400,000. 2 pieces for another cost center and GL account 400,000. Okay, that we'll go for the second item. Second item, so account assignment is same cost center. Material number put here 100-100. Quantity 5. Then delivery date, same delivery date, 3 weeks, 1, 2, 3, 20th of October, plant 1100, enter. Yeah, it will ask to enter cost center 220. So here he is asking to use multiple account assignment. That means 3 pieces for one cost center, 2 pieces for another cost center. Here in the account assignment tab, there is a button called multiple account assignment. Okay, just click this one, this button, multiple account assignment. Yeah, now here this table will open up and three pieces per cost center 1220. Yeah, GL account 400,000. Yeah, 2 pieces per cost center 4300. Same GL account 400,000. Enter. Okay, then it is asking, what it is asking? For partial invoices, distribution should be proportional. Okay, distribution by proportionally, distribute proportionally, this one you need to select. Okay, so here distribution by quantity basis, because we have used quantity here, distribution based on quantity and distribute proportionally. Okay. That is not required. Yeah. Now, everything is fine. we will click this check button, and we will check if every entry, our entries are correct. We got the message, no messages issued during check. That means I can save and create the purchase requisition. Just click this save button. Purchase requisition 1001945 created. Just note down this purchase requisition number 1945. And one more thing, that is we need to use some requirement tracking number PRTI_1001. So here there is a, let us display that purchase requisition. 452. There is a column called tracking number. Here we need to enter it. If you had forgotten, no issue. We can go to change mode and enter it. Click this display change button, and in this tracking number, just put that requirement tracking number. Put that one. Enter. And save. Change. And one more thing, that is select GR non-violated for both the line item. That is, this is already selected here in this valuation, because GR non-violated, because you know this will be selected if we are using multiple account assignment. For item number 2, this is selected by default. For first item, this is not selected, because this is this will be automatically selected if you are using multiple account assignment. First item is only one piece and only one account assignment, so there is no question of this GR non-violated selection by system. For second item, since we have used multiple account assignment, this is selected by system itself. Let us not bother about that one. That will be selected automatically if you are using multiple account assignment. Next is we will display purchase requisition for the requirement tracking number. Just now we have used that one, so that tomorrow, you know, if you want to display, track our purchase requisition, we can track it by using this requirement tracking number. That is the purpose. So transaction code is, I will directly go to the transaction code ME5A. I will take you to another screen. ME5A, enter. Put the requirement tracking number here, this one, and execute. We got this purchase requisition 1001945. This is the requirement tracking number here. So that means tomorrow at any time, by using the requirement tracking number, we can display the purchase requisition. Now, the third one is, third exercise. Create a purchase order with reference to the purchase requisition. Just copy this purchase requisition 1001945 and create the purchase order. So here in the purchase order, we need to use some data. We need to use one vendor 1000, purchase organization 1000, tax code we have to use VA. For our particular vendor. Now I will go to ME21N, create purchase order. Just copy this purchase requisition number 1001945 and put here, put in the purchase requisition column in this create POS, but this is the column, and both item we need to copy. Item number 10, same purchase requisition number. Item number 20. So if you put item 10 and 20 in the two lines, it will copy both the line items from the purchase order. See, it has copied both. The first one is this one without metal master record. Second one is with metal. So everything will be copied. Account assignment, everything. So the purchase organization is 1000. We need to use vendor number 1000, because this vendor has already supplied the material. So we need, let us use the same vendor. Everything is entered. So, and tax code. Tax code we need to use VA. So here VA for both the line items. This is for line item 10. I have used tax code VA. Line item 20 also use the same tax code. Now if you go to the account assignment tab, we can see the whatever we had entered in when creating PR, 3 P's for this GL account. This cost center 1220 and the GL account, 2 pieces for cost center 4300 and GL account 400,000. Everything is fine. Now we will check whether our entries are correct. Yeah. When you click this check button, we got no messages issued during check. I will create the purchase order. Click this save button. Yeah. Purchase order created under number 45001-7841. Just note down this purchase order number 841. Okay. Now, after you create the purchase order, display the purchase requisition and what is the processing status of both purchase requisition items. I will go to this purchase requisition. What is the purchase requisition number we have just now created? Is 19452. Same. Yeah. Here 19452. Here, if you go to the status. Yeah. So before I created the purchase order, the status was not edited. Okay. Now we have already just now created purchase order. Now after I create the purchase order, the status should change to PO created. This is already changed, but I just need to go for this change mode, display change button. Click this one. Yeah. Now status is changed to PO created. Click this button again. See, now in the display mode, status is changed to PO is already created. PO already created. Okay. Next is processing status for both the items it is created. And also, if you go to this contact person tab page here, I can see that is a person who created my user ID, SAP user, and creation indicator. Here in the creation indicator, I can see whether it is created automatically or manually. See, here it is real time or manual. Manually it is created. That is exercise number 4. That is over. Now exercise number 5. Display the purchase requisition with which purchase requisition and with which item is the purchase order for the testing instrument linked. Purchase order with which purchase requisition and which item is the purchase order for the testing instrument linked. In ME23N, we can know the requisition number. So that is again in the display of the purchase order. Okay, so here this is the create PO screen. Just click the other purchase order. So whatever the purchase order we created, it will come here in this one. Enter 7841 here. See, now we can see the purchase requisition number also here. You scroll to the right. Yeah, there is a column here in which you can see the purchase requisition number. Okay. Now post goods receipt for the above purchase order. I will post goods receipt for the purchase order. Yeah, I will open one more screen and go to the MIGO transaction. MIGO. Yeah. 178. What is the purchase order number? 841. Put the PO number, enter. Yeah. Put the delivery note number 178 41. I am using last 5 digit of the purchase order number. Quantity is 1 unit of measure piece. That is for the first item. And click this item. Okay. For the second item, just click on this number 2 button here in the second item. Just click this. Yeah. Yeah, for the second item, put full quantity 5 piece. Okay, here also select item. Okay, now click the check button. Okay, so everything has copied from the purchase order. Everything, just click the check button. Yeah, everything is fine. Document is okay. We got the message. So it is, the status is in green for both the items. I can post the goods receipt document. Just click this post button. Yeah. Okay. Material document 500 ending with 772 posted. This is the GR document number. I will note on this document number 772. Okay. Now, this same material document is updated in the purchase order also. Go to this purchase order. So before posting the acquisition ship, there is this purchase order history tab page was not there. Now after the GR is posted, if I go to the change mode, one purchase order history tab page will open in this PO. I will just click this display change button for this same PO. Yeah, or I will click it again. Yeah, go to the item detail. Yeah, one purchase order history tab has opened. This was not there earlier before posting the goods receipt. Yeah, now I can see the material document number. Okay, next I will go to the exercise number. No? Post invoice for the purchase order. Okay, the transaction code is MIRO. I will go to SAP. I will go to the MIRO transaction code, MIRO, MIRO, enter. So you need to select this first number one, invoice. Second one, you need to put the date. Third one, reference year, purchase order number in the reference tab. Then select this, go to this tab page, PO reference. Okay, here, select this purchase order scheduling agreement. This one, the first one, option one, put the purchase order number 41178 41, and here in this one select goods service items, option number one, enter. Now system has copied all the item details, means cost, material amount, everything from the purchase order. Now tax code it has copied. Now click this calculate tax button. Now the system has automatically calculated taxes, which is coming to $158.18 US dollars. So now next is what is the total amount here? That is the balance it will show here. This is including cost of the material plus the tax. That is the first material is $780, second is $52.50. Plus this tax amount 158.18, that will come to 990.68. Just copy that one and paste here. Remove that minus sign. Okay, enter. Yeah, now enter. The balance has become zero and it is green. That means it can be posted. Now we can post the invoice. Now I will click, before posting, I will click the simulate button. Yeah, here if we click simulate, I can show the different geo accounts to which the cost to the amount is posted. The first one is vendor account, the total amount of the invoice. Second is GRAR clearing account. This is for the first material, consumable material without material master record. The third one and fourth one for the material that will be going to the GL account for consumption raw material. Okay, so for because this material is having master record, it will go to consumption raw material GL account, which is 400,000. Last one is tax account, 154,000, that is the tax amount $158.18. Go back and post the invoice. Save, click save or post. It will post the invoice. And once the invoice is posted, we will get the invoice document number at the bar, in the message bar, and also the same invoice document number will be updated in the purchase order history tab in the purchase order display screen. Invoice is posted. The invoice document number is 510-560-9344. Okay. 9344. This is the invoice document number. Okay. So invoice is also posted. We'll go to the last one. Display the purchase order history records. Okay. Go to the purchase order history and records. Then call up the invoice document number in the purchase order history. Display the accounting document for your invoice and fill out the table on the next page. Here, what we need to do, we need to fill this one, that is to the vendor. For this vendor, this is the vendor. What is this GL account? Then for the first line item, which is the consumable material without master record. This is the GL account and what is the cost, everything. Okay, now I will go to the PO history in the same purchase order. Okay, now after posting the invoice, that invoice document number will also be updated in the purchase order history tab. I will go to this just a display change button. Click it, that will come. Invoice document number. Click it again. Yeah. Go to the item detail. Yeah, here. Invoice document number has come. This one, just know what we posted. Just click on that one. And here, to go to the accounting document, click on this follow on documents button here at the top. Click this one. Yeah. Now, accounting document, the first one, 5100 ending with 9. This is the accounting document created by posting the invoice. Just double click on this one. Yeah. Now we can see the different GL accounts to which, that is the amount is posted. The first one is 1000. This is the vendor account number. First one is, this is the vendor, or vendor number you pushed here, 1000. To the vendor, this total amount 990.68 is posted. 990.68. Second is the first line item, which is the consumable material without material master record, 191100. So the amount is $780. Yeah, this one. This is posted to GRIR clearing account. Second one, the GRIR clearing account, the testing instrument 5105, cost center 1220, amount is 780. Third one, 400,000 GL account number. This is consumption raw material. That is for the three pieces of the second line item, material number 100-100. This one, yeah, line item number 3. This is this for the three pieces. The amount is $21, and the cost center is $1220. Three pieces, $1220, and cost is $21. Okay, the GL account is 400,000, and it is going to consumption raw material one. Okay, that one. Then the fourth line item, that is fourth item in this accounting document, is for the two pieces of the second line item 100-100 for cost center 4300, and the amount is, what is the amount here? 21. The first one is 3150. Yeah, for three pieces of 100 material 100-100, the price is 3150. This is the GL. This is the GL account and cost center. Then, for the two pieces of the second line item, it is posted to cost center 4300, same GL account 400,000, and cost is $21. And the last one is input tax. The GL account is 154,000, and the tax amount is $158.18. This one. This is the last. This is the GL account for the tax. GL account number 154,000. And the amount is 158.18. Okay, so we have done one exercise on the procurement of consumable material, starting from creation of a purchase requisition to posting invoice and displaying the accounting document, and also details of the GL accounts to which the different costs for the materials are posted. Please give me your valuable comments, likes, and please subscribe to my channel so that you will get notification of my upcoming videos on so many scenarios in MM. Thank you for watching my video.